All right, it's another happy Sunday here on Adobo Nation. Kompleto ang barkada. Kasama na si China, si Ted, woo! And don't be surprised, the busiest man of the season, si Mr. Danny Raval joining us here.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Tuwing
December, it's si Santa Claus ang pinaka-busy. Tuwing April, it's Danny Raval.
Understatement.
Understatement of the year. Well, anyway, for those of you that are meeting Danny for the first time, every tax season, he's here to help ang ating mga ka-nation. And the deadline for filing our income tax this year has been pushed out a bit. Hindi na siya April 15, kundi April 18.
Well,
sa ating mga viewers, nagpapanik na kalahati sa kanila dahil hindi pa sila nag-uumpisa filing their taxes.
Nako,
don't worry, Danny is here to help. All right, so let's start because while we were on, before the show started, nalaman natin.
Nagpabida ako, natapos na ako mag-file ng tax. January pa lang ginawa ko na. Pero,
January.
Ikaw din, January. Pero may napansin ako, mayroon po akong na-receive sa mail about, kasi my insurance is Kaiser. Yeah. Tapos parang something about some form. Na,
it's called the Form 1095.
Na tinapon niya.
Na tinapon ko. Ano po ba yun?
Tinan mo, hindi ka kaiba yung ginawa mo. No?
Kasi sabi ko, ano ba yun? Tapos na ako sa mga...
Madami tayong ka-nation na nag-file na ng tax return.
Opo.
Tapos bigla-bigla nag-wave ng 1095 papasok sa opisina.
Ano yun?
Kasi binanong itong 1095 nito, kailangan ko ba mag-amend ng return?
Opo.
So, ang 1095 is generally, ano lang yan, proof of health insurance coverage mo.
Okay po. Actually, ang nag-send sa akin, hindi ko alam kung government o Kaiser. Yeah, tatlo, kasi nga, chung tapon.
Very good ano topic. Tatlo yan eh. Opo. 95A, 95B, 95C.
Kaka-stress!
So, yung A nagsimula ng 2014, i-require yan na ibigay sa mga yung nag-enroll sa covered California dito sa California, yung mga federally funded and state funded na insurance. Yun ang 1095A.
Yes. E question ay, paano kung wala pong insurance? Wala pa rin insurance.
Kung wala insurance, medyo
lagot.
Pero may mga exemption pa rin.
Kasi marami pa rin matitigas ang ulo, hindi kumukuha. Di ba? Parang dinededman nila.
Yeah, yeah.
Ano pong repercussions nun? Or kailangan ko po bang...
Wala naman. If yun lang is proof of insurance. Kung wala kasing insurance, like China said, merong mga penalty minsan. Although may exemption.
So, pero, wala po akong action item?
Walang action item.
Okay.
Not at this time. Pero yung sinasabi mong Kaiser, meron yun yung 1095B, pinuprovide yan effective this year, required ang mga health insurance, other health insurance agencies or provider na mag-produce. Alam mo, pag mabunta ka sa doktor, may card ka na binibigay mo. Yun ang nagpo-provide ng B. Yung C is the employer.
Employer
na bibigay ng C. So, required na ngayon yan. Para nga naman sabihin, sasabi ko ang kliyente ko, may insurance, tapos wala pala.
Wala naman
kaya
pala.
Na yun.
So, in short, hindi po ako dapat mag-panic na hindi ko sinend back. Not yet.
Yeah, no action need to be taken. No action need to be taken. Ano lang yung pagka na-audit, kailangan mo ng kopya. Pero, it's remote.
Wala naman tayong audit. Na ganyan. Insurance.
Well, while we're on the topic of health insurance and Medicaid, yan, related to that. Marami, Danny, sa ating mga ka-nation, nag-aalaga ng mga elderly loved ones, no?
Yes, yes.
And they are, yung mga, nagre-receive sila ng mga payments from the state Medicaid program.
Correct. Yeah.
Ang tanong dyan, kailangan ba nilang magbayad ng taxes for these payments?
Yeah, so in 2014, ang IRS naglabas ng notice na hindi ito taxable, itong mga Medicaid payments for taking care of a loved one in the safety of your home. So, yung mga nag-file ng 12, 13, 14 at tinaksan yun, they can amend and get some money back.
Okay.
And they might be eligible to get some money back, provided they meet some requirements. Malaki yun. $20,000 na tinaksan ng 12, at 20%, that's $4,000.
Wow!
Times 3 years, 12,000.
Pwede na magbagong buhay.
Mag-isa lang na kasi kung hindi mo sinabi, di parang dinedma lang nila, di ba? Meron pa rin silang buhok.
Oo, madami pa. In-announce natin yung last year, madami na tulungan, and yet, ang dami pa rin di nakakaalam na it's not taxable.
Tapos po,
are there any best ups? Go ahead.
Yeah. So, kasi po, di ba, for sure, yung mga iba mag-extend.
Yes.
Kasi hindi pa sila ready. Meron po bang fee yun? Meron po bang...
Pwede mag-file, no? So, gahul na sa panahon. We have several days left to April 18. Pag nag-file, it will extend their filing deadline to October 17 instead of 15 kasi 15 falls on a Saturday. Ang filing, extension to file is not an extension to pay. No? You avoid the filing penalty payment, pero yung filing payment penalty, hindi na-avoid. So you need to to pay in advance or pay on the deadline, yung tax owed pa rin, to avoid payment penalty.
Buti hindi natin problema yan ngayon.
Very good tayo.
Very good kami.
So you see this happening every year. It's almost like cyclical siya, no? You know, we're at the start of April now. We have a lot of Canadians who have either already filed, not yet filed, don't know where to start. What would be your best sort of advice or best practice sa mga viewers natin?
Yeah, so yung mga deadline na April 15, April 18 this time, kailangan maghabol before April 18. Mm-hmm. File an extension if you cannot file on time. Mm-hmm. So that will give you another, from April to October, another 6 months to gather all your documents.
And one thing I can't stress enough sa ating mga viewers, you know, if you talk to a professional like Danny here, he will point out places where you can actually save and get money back that you wouldn't otherwise have known on your own. Mm-hmm. Is this true?
Marami niyan yung tumaas yung bracket, ano, pwede mapababa yung bracket. You still have time mag-invest sa traditional IRA if you're qualified. That will bring your adjustment gross income down. Mm-hmm. And madaming ma-avail mong benefits sa ganon. Mm-hmm. If you owe the IRS, pwede ka mag-installment agreement. You don't have to pay that. Huwag matakot na hindi mabayaran yung utang, mm-hmm. or not to file. Put an installment agreement. You still have to pay interest and penalties, pero at least na installment.
So, but there's many options, no?
Yeah, may mga options. Yeah.
And before we go really quickly, someone that does their taxes on their own versus someone who goes through a professional like you, is there a dollar amount or a percentage that you can say difference na nasa-save, na refund nila?
Yeah, so if you use like software, no, off-the-shelf software, it's good to use it, pero you still have to understand yung back-end on it. Saan ang gagaling, no? May yes or no questions. Sometimes yung yes or no questions, mahirap sagutin talaga. Eh. Mm-hmm. It's borderline. So you need to analyze and weigh kung ano talaga yung tinatanong.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. So,
dami na naraman.
Again, we'd like to thank Danny for taking time off his busy schedule this time of the year. And of course, if you need help or have any questions whatsoever with your taxes, Danny, how can they reach you?
You can reach us by calling us 650-757-5333 is the phone number. And we're located at 2760 Junipero Serra Boulevard in Daly City, California.
Okay. And in the past years, I remember if they call and they mention a donation, meron daw discount?
Siyempre naman. No. We said 30% last year. Let's keep it at 30%.
Whoa.
And call us. We will extend. We will file your extension for free. Just mention a donation, of course.
There you go. Very generous. Maraming salamat, Danny, as always.
Thank you so much for having me.